One thing that I've absolutely loved using was the Amazon Fire Stick.
Now the Chromecast is pretty much the exact same thing except in white. First of all, look to the back of your TV to find your HDMI connections. And all you need is a power source and you're good to go. And this is what it looks like plugged in. The top I've got here, the Fire Stick.
Hi guys, this is Stella Bella. Hi everyone, welcome back to the Hubie and Talon channel. This is Stella Bella. So, with all of the streaming apps that there are out there today, we are spoiled for choice with what movies and shows to watch and what channel to watch them on. As someone who subscribes to a ton of these streaming services and without a smart TV, it can sometimes be a little bit difficult trying to pick a movie to watch because I'm going across so many different apps. One thing that I've absolutely loved using was the Amazon Fire Stick, which is one of these babies. I've been using these for years now and it's not failed me once. I've even got them for my friends because they're so useful. And I used to use the Nvidia Shield, but they are very expensive. Whereas an Amazon Fire Stick for a light version is only around 29 AUD. And for the 4K Max version, it's about $49 to $59. So it's very affordable compared to something like the Nvidia Shield, which is around a couple of $100s. It does have more features, but for something like watching basic movies, TV shows and things like that, the Fire Stick has been amazing. But what has recently come out, what has recently caught my attention is the Google Chromecast, which is this one. And price point is roughly the same as the Amazon Fire Stick, and it does pretty much the same thing, maybe even a little bit more, because I did find a streaming service on the Google Chromecast that wasn't available on the Amazon Fire Stick that I've always wanted. And that is the reason why I got this in the first place. So today I'm going to do a quick comparison and review of the two products so that you can know what you should buy.
First of all, let's have a look at the Amazon Fire Stick. This is the 4K Max version. And up the top, it shows their most popular apps that you can get on the Fire Stick. But of course, there are so many more, like thousands and thousands more. Now, the Fire Stick is linked to Amazon, so it will link with your Amazon Prime account really easily. And it also works well with Alexa and all the other Amazon services. The box itself is very sleek, black and orange with embossed detailing and texture. Next, let's have a look at the Google Chromecast, and the box is just as compact and just as sophisticated, but of course it is white. And I've always thought Google has a little bit of an Apple product feel to it. And just like the Fire Stick and its affiliation with Amazon, the Google Chromecast can be used with Google Assistant and your Google account with Google Apps and Google Play Store. So what's included in the Amazon Fire Stick box is the dongle, which connects to the HDMI connection of your TV, the power cable with a power connection, two AAA alkaline batteries, and a voice remote control, all in its signature black. Now the Chromecast is pretty much the exact same thing except in white. And we have the dongle, which also goes into the HDMI connection on your TV, the power cable, also two AAA alkaline batteries, which is for your remote control, by the way, and also the voice remote control. First of all, look to the back of your TV to find your HDMI connections. And all you need is a power source and you're good to go. And this is what it looks like plugged in. The top I've got here, the Fire Stick. And that's plugged into the first HDMI, and the Chromecast is plugged into the second HDMI. And at the same time, it's also plugged into a power source. Now let's have a look at the Fire Stick first, because that's the one I've been using and I'm familiar with. This is the dashboard interface. And as you can see, everything is laid out very neatly. You've got different categories. Usually the things that you access the most, or what Amazon Fire Stick would like you to access the most, are up the top. Your most used apps, the most popular apps, latest TV shows that you've watched, things that are recommended to you, as well as the apps that you've downloaded. And there are a lot of apps to choose from. Now they've got all your most popular ones, of course, Netflix, Disney Plus, Amazon, Amazon Music. But if you have a look, at all the different categories that they have, they actually have thousands and thousands of apps. Entertainment alone, you've got all the different channels, even local channels like Channel 10 for Australia, Channel 7, but also Stan, Binge, Netflix, Prime, and all of these obscure movie channels. And these are channels from all around the world and totally niche as well, focusing on very different topics. There's also a lot of games to choose from. My favorite is Crossy Road, and I've been obsessed with playing this game for a long time. But apart from that, a lot of other games. Now let's have a look at the search interface and how well it actually searches for things. So if I was to look up a movie using the Fire Stick, I can just type in the name, and this is on the homepage of the Fire Stick, so the dashboard. I can look up, say for example, Avengers, and it'll come up with the results and what channel is on as well. So if I've got the app, it'll suggest that I can watch now using the app. So this is on Disney Plus. And if I don't have the app, it'll tell me exactly where I can find the movie and then try to download the app for me. And because the Fire Stick has so many apps, it's very rare to find something that you cannot access. They have SBS Plus, Tubi, all the other channels, so that if there is something that you want to watch, that will take you straight to the site to sign up. Now let's compare this to the Chromecast. At first glance, the layout is very similar. In terms of usability, flowiness, smoothness, it is a little bit better than the Fire Stick. Now, I'm not sure if it's because I've had the Fire Stick for a little bit longer or because the Chromecast itself, technology-wise, is a little bit newer, but it does flow a little bit smoother in terms of even just the remote control, how well things click and work together. The thing I love about Chromecast and the reason why I got it is purely because they've got an app that the Fire Stick doesn't, and that is the TV Be Anywhere app. Now, I love my Hong Kong drama. I'm from Hong Kong, and TVB is the station of Hong Kong. And I've been dying to watch a lot of those Hong Kong TV shows, and this is the channel that does it. Unfortunately, the app is not available on Fire Sticks. So this one does win for me a little bit, the Chromecast, because of the TVB app. But apart from that, everything else is pretty much the same as the Fire Stick. Now, if you have a look at categorizing, pretty much the same. It favors its own company. So in terms of Google Apps, it favors all of those. Whereas Amazon Fire Stick, you will see a lot of Prime, Amazon recommendations. Now, because Google Chrome is linked to your Google account or Google Play Store, a lot of the apps are downloadable from the Play Store. So instead of the Fire Stick, where it seems like everything is pretty much built in, here, it'll take you to the Google Play Store to download any apps that the device itself doesn't have. In saying that though, it does mean that compatibility-wise might not be as smooth because you're essentially downloading it from the Google Play Store, which is a third-party app, rather than within the device itself. Now, in terms of searchability, let's have a try of searching for Avengers again on the Chromecast. And here it comes up exactly the same as the Fire Stick. It tells you exactly which app streams this particular movie, and it takes you straight there. Now, one thing I do notice about the Chromecast is that it likes to lay out everything in the scroll across format. So instead of the Fire Stick, where we saw it was able to lay it all out on the same page and you scroll down, this one scrolls across, which each to their own, but I personally prefer the full page view and being able to scroll down and see everything in the one page. Another downfall about the Chromecast is that with games like my favorite, Crossy Road, even if you install it, you need a gamepad in order to play it on the Chromecast. Whereas on the Fire Stick, all you need to do is just download the game and you can actually play it with the remote control, which is awesome. And it just makes it a lot more easier to access and a lot more fun as well. Because there are so many games on offer on the Fire Stick, and so does the Google Play Store. If you're able to just use the remote control to play those games, it'll make it so much more convenient. But apart from that, the Google Chromecast is pretty similar to the Fire Stick, and they both each have their pros and cons. The only downfall I find with the Chromecast, which does run slightly better and faster than the Fire Stick, The only downfalls are just the games, not having TVB, and personal preference, scroll across interface versus the full page view.
Okay, so I hope that provides a good basic comparison of the two devices. And if you've been looking at getting one for yourself, now you can decide whether or not the Fire Stick or the Chromecast will be better for you. I have both. I feel like I'm going to be using Chromecast a little more. Just the added bonus of having that extra app that I'm keen on all in the one place is super handy. Now, of course, if you're more of a Prime person and you prefer to have more of your Prime apps available to you, Fire Stick is amazing. And if the TVB app is not important to you whatsoever, and the Fire Stick pretty much has everything that you want and need anyway, then it seems like that one would be more suitable for you, but each to their own. I hope I've helped you a little bit in making a decision today. If you've got any comments, questions, please drop it down below. Make sure to follow us as well. Click like, subscribe, follow on our social media channels. And please follow me on social media. I am also on Instagram, TikTok, and Facebook under stellabella.au. I would love to hear from you. Thank you all so much for listening today. I've had a blast reviewing this product for you, and I look forward to bringing you more products, more mindset videos, and more skincare videos in the near future. I hope you all have a wonderful week, and I'll catch you next time. Bye.